أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهديه الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلن تجد له من دون الله وليا مرشدا. الحمد لله رب الناس ملك الناس إله الناس، الحمد لله الفرد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. ثم أما بعد، My dear respected brother and sister Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. With the blessing of Allah Azza wa Jal, we are back again after a short holiday. And so many brothers, alhamdulillah, they went to visit the families and enjoy themselves. And they're still waiting for some other brother, inshallah, they will come from overseas. But to always feel blessed from Allah Azza wa Jal to use us and to allow us to come to the masjid and to continue our ilm, alhamdulillah, rabbil alameen. To continue our lecture, to continue our lessons. And wallahi, my brother, a great blessing from Allah Azza wa Jal. So for this blessing, we should thank Allah Azza wa Jal. He allow us to come to his masjid. He allow us to be the mu'mineen who come to fill up the masjid of Allah Azza wa Jal. That's great blessing from Allah Azza wa Jal. As we said, inshallah, we're going to have some time to talk about the right and the duty of the Muslims in Islam. And wallahi, my brothers, this topic is very important, because we always say one day you will leave this dunya and you will be in front of Allah Azza wa Jal, and you will be asked questions and you have to answer the questions. And every answer you're going to give is according to right or duty. And if you don't have the right answer, my brothers, don't blame anyone else, blame yourself. Allah Azza wa Jal said in the Quran, أَفَحَسِبْتُمْ أَنَّمَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ عَبَثًا وَأَنَّكُمْ إِلَيْنَا لَا تُرْجَعُونَ. Do you think Allah Azza wa Jal creates you from nothing? And you're not going to go back to Allah Azza wa Jal? Do you think so? If you think so, my brother, you're mistaken. If you think so, my sister, you're mistaken. One day we have to go back to Allah Azza wa Jal. And Allah Azza wa Jal, he never creates us for nothing. There is a purpose for Allah Azza wa Jal to create us. And all of us, you know the great purpose of Allah Azza wa Jal creating us. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. Allah doesn't need our money. Allah doesn't need our effort. Allah doesn't need our ibadah. Allah doesn't need anything from us. We need Allah. We worship Allah Azza wa Jal because we need Allah Azza wa Jal. ما أريد منهم من رزق وما أريد أن يطعمون. I don't need risk from you. Allah Azza wa Jal doesn't need risk from us. He's the one who provides us the risk. وما أريد أن يطعمون. Allah doesn't need food from us. He's the one who sends the food to us. إن الله هو الرزاق ذو القوة المتين. Allah Azza wa Jal, He's the one who sends the risk to us with the power. So Allah Azza wa Jal create us for purpose. And when He create us, He give us right. Like, wallahi, my brother, where can you find these things? If you get a slave, if you go back to read the history about the slavery before Islam, the slaves has no right, the human being to human being. The master, the owner, he has all the right. Even one of his right, he can kill his slave and nobody can ask him why he did that. Nobody can question him. He can do whatever he wants, he can punish him, he can torture him, he can do whatever he wants. There is no right for the slaves. He bought him with his money and he can use him as much as he can and he can do whatever he wants. If even he kill him, nobody can blame him for that, nobody even can question him. But Allah Azza wa Jal, when he create us, he give us right. He give us right. And the first right Allah Azza wa Jal has given to us, He wrote it on the door of the Jannah. He wrote it on the arsh. إِنِّي حَرَّمْتُ الظُّلْمَ عَلَىٰ نَفْسِي وَجَعَلْتُهُ مُحَرَّمٌ بَيْنَكُمْ. I make the unjust forbidden for myself. I'm not going to be unjust to you. Allah Azza wa Jal, the first things He give us a right, He's not going to be unjust to us. He's going to be just. And wallahi, if Allah Azza wa Jal is unjust to us, nobody can question Him. And nobody can do anything. He can do whatever he wants. He can create all of us and put all of us in Jannah or in the hellfire. Nobody can question. But Allah Azza wa Jalla said, I make the unjust forbidden for myself. And I don't want you to be unjust to each other as well. But first Allah Azza wa Jalla give us right. And he give us another right. And he write it on the top of the arsh. Rahmati sabaqat ghadabi. My mercy become before my anger. That's why I see my brother, wallahi, the people, they do a lot of bad things to Allah Azza wa Jalla. Wallahi, if somebody did for me one bad things once, maybe I'll forgive him. Second, I'll say it's all right. Third, I'll start to become cranky. Fourth, I won't take it. Fifth, I'll start fight. That's it. Finish. This person, he always do it on purpose. He knows what he's doing. Every time he do something bad for me. Every time. And I cannot take it anymore. Whoever patient person, he cannot take it more than 20 or 100 or whatever. But Allah Azza wa Jal, you're making every day bad deed. And some people, they do it every day on purpose. And they still Allah Azza wa Jal, because he give us right, he said, Rahmati, my mercy, become before my anger. So he never become angry at us. He give us more chance. Take another chance. Tomorrow, maybe you repent to me. Maybe after tomorrow, maybe next year, maybe you live 100 years or 50 or 60, and Allah Azza wa Jal every day give you chance to come back again to him. So he's giving you right. Before he ask any of your duty, before even he create you, before even he create Adam alayhi salam, he gives his right to son of Adam before he come to the dunya. Before Adam he come to the dunya. So Allah Azza wa Jal, he will never be unjust to anybody. وَمَا رَبُّكَ بِظَلَّامٍ لِلْعَبِيدِ Allah Azza wa Jal, in the Quran, Allah said so. He will never be unjust to his slave. Never ever. But Ya Allah, there is kafir, even the kafir. I will never be unjust to him. Ya Allah, there is people, they make bad deeds every day. I will never be unjust to them. Ya Allah, there is people, they kill people and they have no mercy. But I still, I will have mercy for them. That's Allah Azza wa Jal, my brothers. That's Allah Azza wa Jal. So Allah give you right before he ask your duty. But you as a Muslim, you as a believer, you should ask yourself, what is my duty to Allah Azza wa Jal? I know my right already. That's why the hadith we mentioned last Friday when the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he asked Mu'az ibn Jabal and he said, Ya Mu'az, do you know what is the right of the slaves from Allah Azza wa Jal? He said, Allah and his Prophet know best. I don't know. And the Prophet walked with him an hour without giving him the answer. And he said, do you know, first he said to him, do you know what is the right of Allah Azza wa Jal from his slave? He said, Allah and his Prophet knows best. And after an hour, he asked another question, do you know what is the right of the slaves from Allah Azza wa Jal? He said, Allah and his Prophet knows best. And then the Prophet ﷺ tell him, the right of Allah Azza wa Jal among his slaves to worship him and don't commit blasphemy, don't have partner with Allah Azza wa Jal ever. That's the right of Allah Azza wa Jal. That's what Allah Azza wa Jal asking us. To say La ilaha illallah. Not to have any partner with Allah Azza wa Jal. So what is the right of us if we did that? That's a condition. You have to do that first. You have to believe in Allah Azza wa Jal. And not commit blasphemy with Allah Azza wa Jal. Not to have a partner or son or daughter or whatever. What is our right in this case? Allah, the Prophet ﷺ said, Ya Mu'az, if the people did that, the right from Allah Azza wa Jal not to punish them, not to put them in the hellfire. They put them in the Jannah, inshaAllah. So now, there is a right and duty. You get your right, and now your duty. And if you do your duty, you get another right, you get the Jannah, inshaAllah. So as soon as you become a believer, Allah Azza wa Jal guarantee a Jannah for you, inshaAllah. That's why Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he sent Abu Huraira one day and he said, Ya Abu Huraira, go tell the people, whoever you meet, whoever die on a state of La ilaha illallah or Islam and last word for him, La ilaha illallah, I guarantee Jannah for him. Because he's not kafir, he's not having another partner with Allah Azza wa Jal. So Allah Azza wa Jal did create us from nothing, my brothers and sisters. Allah Azza wa Jal gave us right. And then there is a duty we have to do it for Allah Azza wa Jal. And the first thing, my brother, we got so many duties. But wallahi, wallahi, wallahi. Because when you swear on some things, Allah Azza wa Jal, He swear for things. He knows the things is guaranteed for us. And when we swear about things now, Allah Azza wa Jal guaranteed for us the things. Wallahi, my brothers, if you do your duty for Allah Azza wa Jal, you will enjoy what you're doing. Because sometimes some people, they take this duty as a heavy things. The duty of the salah, the duty of the siyam, the duty of the zakah, I have to give my money. The duty of the hajj, I have to spend too much money now. The duty of the sadaqah, a lot of duty. And some people just start feel that's too much. Too much duty, I cannot do it. Wallahi, the mu'min, the believer, he enjoy it. Because the first duty we're going to talk about it today, for Allah Azza wa Jalla himself. To know Allah Azza wa Jalla first. Because as soon as you love Allah, as soon as you know Allah Azza wa Jalla and you love Allah, wallahi, everything after that easy. Because when you love somebody, you will do whatever he wants. As soon as you love somebody, you will do whatever he asks you with good feeling. That's why Ibn Qayyim, he said, Masakinu ahli dunya. The people of the dunya, the people who love the dunya, masakin, poor. He feels sorry for them. Why? He said, when they leave the dunya, they don't taste the sweetness of the dunya. But there is people, they're very rich. They got big houses, they got cars, they got money, they got everything. What else do they need? No, this is not the sweetness of the dunya. He said, what is the sweetness of the dunya? He said, to know Allah Azza wa Jal. If you come out of the dunya, my brother, if you die, and you didn't know Allah, you didn't taste the sweetness of the dunya. You need to know the purpose for why Allah Azza wa Jal created you. So you need first to know Allah. What is the right of Allah Azza wa Jal from me as a Muslim? What is my duty to Allah Azza wa Jal? The first, my brother, very important things. Your aqidah, your belief, what you follow. You said, La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. You are a Muslim. That's aqidah. Isn't it? So you need to know Allah Azza wa Jal, His name and attribute. Alhamdulillah, we studied this like some time ago. And inshallah, we're gonna finish it step bit by bit, inshallah, because we need to finish all the names and attributes of Allah Azza wa Jal yet. But if I finish it or not, your duty is to search about it. Your duty to read about the names and attributes of Allah Azza wa Jal. You need to know Allah, the one who created you. The one who supports you, the one who look after you and your family and you and everything's in your life, in your business, your money, Allah Azza wa Jal. And you don't know Allah? So you need to know Allah Azza wa Jal, you need to know His names, and you need to know His attributes. And you need to know the aqeedah. The aqeedah of the Muslims, when you believe in Allah Azza wa Jal, you got shirk wal-iyazu billah. Partner with Allah Azza wa Jal. And the partner is two ways, my brothers. Once, we know people, they worship another God with Allah Azza wa Jal, another thing with Allah Azza wa Jal and call him God. There's no other God besides Allah Azza wa Jal. But he have another partner. He makes son to Allah, he make daughter to Allah, he make wife to Allah, he make a partner with Allah Azza wa Jal. His aqidah is wrong. But also there is another shirk wal iyazu billah. When you do the things, you do good deed. For the people, not for Allah Azza wa Jal. Al-shirk al-khafi, the hidden shirk. You in front of the people, doing the best. But between you and Allah Azza wa Jal, you don't even pray. Or this person doesn't even give sadaqah in front of the people. When there is people giving sadaqah, he takes the sadaqah given. So everybody can watch me, I'm giving sadaqah, you see? But if he's alone, and somebody poor, need whatever, doesn't care. In front of the people, he pray. Between him and Allah Azza wa Jal, yes, he pray, but the different, big difference between his prayer in front of the people, as we said today in the khutbah, Ibn Mas'ud, he said, if you pray in front of the people, and you give your best of the salah in front of the people, and when you be between you and Allah Azza wa Jal, you make the salah just quick, لَقَدْ جَعَلْتَ اللَّهَ أَهْوَنِ النَّاظِرِينَ إِلَيْكَ. You make Allah Azza wa Jal, the most little one, he look at you, quickly, 1 minute salah, 2 minutes salah, but in front of the people, 10 minutes. Because everybody's watching me. Everybody must know I'm a good man. I'm the top of the people. And one sheikh was saying, like, a man who was praying and is making long in the salah, mashallah. So two people, they was watching him and they start to talk, mashallah, look at his prayer. Look at his sujood, mashallah. Take long. Look at zuku', mashallah. Stand for a long time. And mashallah, he's a very good man. So like he become like very heavy. So he makes the salah more longer. And then when they finish, he said, by the way, I'm also fasting. Just to let them know, like, he got extra things. Like, in the salah, he talked to them. Just to let them know, like, he's, mashallah, he's like, he's a very good man. So some people, they want the people to know how much we are good. But between them and Allah, Azza wa Jal, it's finished. I'm done, alhamdulillah. So the first thing, my brother, you need to know Allah, Azza wa Jal, his name and his attribute. That's Allah. That's one you follow. And the second stage, my brother, you need to start with your Islam. You need to know your Islam. You need to practice your Islam. We know Islam, five pillars. All our children know it very well. If you ask any of the children, what is the pillars of Islam? Shahadat an la ilaha illallah, wa anna Muhammad Rasulullah, qam al-salah, ta'i zakah, sawm Ramadan, hajj al-bayt. Everybody know it. So you have to practice. But there is big difference. With Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the burden, the people, they come to him to tell him, Ya Rasulullah, we are believer. يَمُنُونَ عَلَيْكَ أَنْ أَسْلَمُوا. They wanted to, like to show Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we did a favor for you, Muhammad, to become a Muslim. You know? Like sometime when some people, they come to the lecture, they said, Shaykh, you see, we're coming to you. Don't come to me. Come to Allah Azza wa Jal. I don't need you. You need to come to Allah. So, they come to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, saying, you see, Muhammad, we did a favor for you, become a Muslim. So Allah Azza wa Jal answer. قالت الأعراب آمنا. The man said, we become believer. Allah Azza tell him, tell them Muhammad, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tell them. قالت الأعراب أنا قل لم تؤمنوا. You're not a believer yet. ولكن قولوا أسلمنا. Some translation, some tafsir, they said, Allah Azza wa Jal tell them that. You just say, oh, I'm Muslim because you're scared to get killed. That's why, subhanAllah, you see, my brothers, Islam, as we always say, sometimes you become sick, but you will never die. Our situation now, Islam is sick. But inshallah, we'll never die. When Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passed away, in the last Hajj, who was the first and the last for him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Hajjatul Wada', he had 120,000 followers, 1,000 Muslims. But when he died, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so many people left Islam. Until they said, there was only 3 masjids in the whole world people praying in. No other masjid make salah, make qama, make adhan. Only 3 masjids. Only 3 masjids, my brother, in this time, they used to call the adhan and the people used to pray. The amount of the Muslim dropped too much. Because Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam died. Because some people, they think the da'wah is for the person who made the da'wah, not for Allah Azza wa Jal. So a lot of people, they left Islam. And they come to the situation, 3 masjid only. They call in the adhan in these 3 masjid and they pray in this masjid, nobody. But Abu Bakr and Umar and Uthman and the great Sahaba, they stood up for Islam. And they fought for Islam. And they made the Islam to come back again healthy. In the year of 417, that was a great bad things happened to the Muslims as well. There was a group of people, they attacked the Kaaba. And the man, the leader of these people, he starts saying, I am Allah. He said so, I am Allah. Allah created the people and I killed the people. And he said, what is the Tar al-Ababil? What is the Hijara from Sijjil? Because he destroyed the Kaaba and he took the black stone, it was in his castle for 20 years. There was no Kaaba for 20 years. But Islam never die as well. Islam come back again, very strong again. That's why, my brother, you need to know your Islam. You need to know everything about your Islam. You are Muslim, you should be proud of your Islam. That's a stage for your duty as well, to practice your Islam. And if anything happens to the Islam, don't worry. The one who creates Islam is Allah Azza wa Jal. He look after. You look after yourself. If there is a time of fitna, stay on Islam. don't leave the Islam because everybody leave. Ibn Qayyim said, if you see all the people walking in one side, on the wrong side, and you only one person on the haq, on the truth, stay there. Don't follow them. Because when they go, all of them to the hellfire, you won't be happy to be with them. You want to be on the other way to the Jannah, inshallah. That's how the person should think about when he follow the right, the haq. It doesn't matter if I'm only one person on the right way, on the haq, I will stay on this way. But everybody else watching movie, watching TV, everybody else like gambling, everybody else making zina, why only me? It's very hard, Shaykh, to be only alone in one place. I'm working in a place, in a company, not even one Muslim. I'm shy to pray. I'm shy to say I'm a Muslim. I'm shy to say I'm Muhammad. My name is Muhammad. But wallahi, my brother, if the whole building on one side, but you on the side of Allah Azza wa Jal, you are the winner because you got Islam. And second stage, my brother, from your duty, from your wajib for Islam, the iman, you must start take the step up. Muslims, I pray whatever I practice Islam, iman. You start believe in the things you don't see it. You don't see Allah Azza wa Jalla. You don't see the angels. You never see the revealed of the books, but you believe in all the things. You believe in the qadr. Things happen to you bad. Why Allah did that? What is wisdom behind that? If you don't know now, you will know it later, inshallah. So you believe in the qadr, good or bad, test sweet or test sour. Doesn't matter. The Prophet ﷺ tells exactly that in the hadith. That's how you step. You take your step, another step. That's another duty. To go from Islam to Iman. And then after that, you go to the Ihsan. To worship Allah Azza wa Jal. All of us know the hadith. As Allah is watching you. And if you cannot see Allah watching me, you must feel, I watch Allah Azza wa Jal. And today I was talking about Hassan al-Basri. When he was saying one of the things to make him Zahid. He said, because I know Allah Azza wa Jalla is watching me, I feel shy to make sin. I cannot make sin because I know Allah Azza wa Jalla is watching me. Abdullah al-Tistiri, you said he start from 3 years old to learn few words. Allahu ma'i, Allah with me. Allahu nadirun ilayhi, Allah is watching me. Allahu shahidun alayhi, Allah is going to be witness on me. These 3 words, my brothers, it make Abdullah al-Tistiri one of the great ulama, one of the great zuhad, people that doesn't care about the dunya. In his story, you won't believe. This guy is to live 1 year for one dirham because he is to eat only bread and salt. 1 year, his expenses, one dirham. He doesn't care, he's just worried about the hereafter. I'm not saying be poor or anything like that, but at least, my brothers, when you come to your duty, worship Allah Azza wa Jal, as Allah Azza wa Jal is watching you. Allah Azza wa Jal. There is a car, I need to be moved, brother, please.
BCK 83K.
So if you can just move it, please, brother. So when you worship Allah Azza wa Jal, worship Allah Azza wa Jal, as Allah is watching you. And that's how Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was teaching the Sahaba. That's your duty, my brother, for the Iman. The fifth level, when you come to the level of Ubudiyya, when you understand and you feel, and you love to be abd to Allah Azza wa Jal, and you love to be slave to Allah Azza wa Jal, and I always explain that there is big difference. Because some people, they said, don't say, we are abd to Allah. No, we are ibadullah. Because Allah Azza wa Jal, he described Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in a very high things for him, he said, Subhanalladhi asra bi'abdihi laylan min al-masjid al-haram ila al-masjid al-aqsa bi'abdihi. And that's great honor for Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam to be abd to Allah Azza wa Jal. So yes, we are ibad of Allah Azza wa Jal, and we worship Allah Azza wa Jal. And when you come to this level, my brothers, you should have the honor. I am a slave to Allah Azza wa Jal. Because all the benefit is coming to you from Allah. All the right is coming to you from Allah Azza wa Jal. So you start to go in the level of ubudiyya to Allah Azza wa Jal. And the ubudiyya, my brothers, is to turn everything of your life to Allah Azza wa Jal. Anything, any ibadah. To change the culture to ibadah. So can I change the culture? Yes. We do a lot of culture, my brother, in our life. If we just have the right intention for this culture, it becomes ibadah. You get reward. But if you do it because it's culture, you get nothing. Because the Prophet ﷺ in the hadith, he said, إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَّةِ. You did according to your intention. A person can stand next to you pray for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal, and he pray not for Allah Azza wa Jal. He get nothing. He get nothing. But you, because you pray for Allah Azza wa Jal, you get something. You give sadaqah and he give sadaqah, he get nothing because he give it because of show off. So, if I always get people to my house, that's aada, culture. I do it every time. Why you don't make it ibadah? Why you don't have intention to get these people for dhikr of Allah Azza wa Jal? For lecture, you invite some brother, he knows some deen or some ilm, and he, come. That's not because of anything, so we're not doing anything out of the sunnah. That's just because I like to invite some brothers and I will get somebody to talk about the Prophet ﷺ or talk whatever, do it, no problem. No problem. So change the culture to ibadah to Allah Azza wa Jal. So that's very, very high rank, my brother. Also, one of the very important things, when we come to talk about our duty to Allah Azza wa Jal, very important things. To do the awamir of Allah Azza wa Jal, to do the order of Allah. Allah's ordering us, my brother, to do things. And that's the main things for our lecture. When you come to do your duty, it means whatever Allah Azza wa Jal ordering you, you have to do it. And Allah Azza wa Jal has so many things to order us. Take few things, but there is plenty. Plenty Allah Azza wa Jal ordering us. And wallahi, my brother, everything Allah is ordering us is good for us. Allah in the Quran said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُ بِالْعَدْلِ وَالْإِحْسَانِ وَإِتَاءِ ذِي الْقُرْبَى وَيَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ وَالْبَغْيِ يَعِدُكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَذَكَّرُونَ. Allah Azza wa Jal, He's ordering you العدل, to be just. والإحسان, الإحسان, my brother, above what Allah asking you. If Allah asking you to do one and you did two, in the same way, not innovation, not outside, in the same way, that's إحسان. So if a person come and you need to be just with him, because this person, he did something bad to you, and the just to do the same bad thing to him, but al-ihsan to forgive him. Allah love that. يَأْمَرُ بِالْعَدْلِ وَالْإِحْسَانِ وَإِتَاءِ ذِي الْقُرْبَى, to come to your related, to connect your relationship. وَيَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ وَالْبَغْيِ, and he's ordering you not to do the bad things. So that's what Allah Azza wa Jal asked. So one of the order of Allah Azza wa Jal, and the first things what to talk about it, وَإِلَهُكُمْ إِلَهٌ وَاحِدٌ إِنَّ إِلَهُكُمْ لَوَاحِدٌ. Allah Azza wa Jal is only one. He's ordering us to worship Him. That's the first order. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. So Allah Azza wa Jal first right, my brother, for His order, to worship Him and to don't commit blasphemy with Him with anybody else. The second order, Allah Azza wa Jal is ordering us to follow Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَمَا أَتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا. Whatever the Prophet bring to you, take it. And whatever the Prophet tell you, don't do it. انتهوا. My brother, the word of انتهوا, they had with the Sahaba a very great respect. Very great respect. When Allah Azza talked about the wine, فَهَلْ أَنْتُمْ مُنْتَهُونَ, are you going to stop? In this, after the ayah being delivered to the Prophet ﷺ, revealed to the Prophet ﷺ, that was the stopping of the Sahaba to drink wine. Finish. Intahu, it's finished. Not intahu, like take some time, think about it. Let me practice, because wallah, it's very hard for me to wear the hijab. It's very hard to start praying. It's very hard, everything, I need practice. I'm not saying push the people, but I'm talking about the people who become to the level to love Allah Azza wa Jal. The level to know the duty to Allah Azza wa Jal. When you know there is an order, you have to start acting quickly. If you are a good believer, that's why we said, when the Sahaba Allah tell them, no more wine, The Medina was muddy. Because everybody has wine, you throw it away. When Allah Azza tell the sisters, wear the hijab, any woman she was sitting without hijab, she started to get any material to cover her hair in the same place. She didn't say, all right, when I go home, I will see what I got and I will get the hair, the dresser to make it. No. In the same place, she started to get something to cover her hijab because Allah said, wear the hijab. So we follow Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with careful to make any innovation for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sunnah. We have to follow exactly what Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam bring for us to Allah Jal. After that, another order to be good to your parents. That's order. وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ قَضَى. Some people, my brother, they get confused between qada and qada. Both of them in Arabic, very similar. But the qada, Allah Azza wa Jalla, he's making order and it's up to you to follow it or not. But the qada, the destiny, Allah make it if you want it or not. You cannot do anything. When Allah Azza wa Jalla write your risk, you cannot get extra one breath. You cannot get extra $1. You cannot do anything. That's your qada. That's your destiny. But the qada, because some people they get confused between these two. Qada, Allah Azza wa Jalla order you to do some things. If you don't do it, you get punishment. If you do it, you get reward. So Allah Azza wa Jalla said, وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّا وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. That's why some people said, how come Allah, he made qada to worship him and some people kafir. That's why you answer him, said qada, Allah leaves the choice for you. He ordered you to do it, but he leaves the choice for you. That's why the people who believe in Allah go to Jannah. The people who doesn't believe, they don't go to Jannah. The people, they look after the parents. Al-Jannah تحت أقدام الأمهات. He said, if you want the Jannah, it's under your mother's feet. Do whatever your mother said, as long as he ordered you to do the halal things. So to follow Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and then to be good to your parents, one of the order of Allah Azza wa Jal. Another order, whatever comes from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, also we have to do. When a person comes to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Ya Rasulullah, advise me. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, don't become angry. So be careful to become angry, my brothers. Because wallahi, the anger is destroying a lot of houses. The anger, most of the people in the jail, when you ask them why you in the jail, they said, I was angry, so I stabbed him. I was angry, so I hit my wife. I was angry. Every question is going to be the majority, 90% of the people in jail because of the anger. That's why the Prophet used to say, don't become angry. Because the shaitan, he will control you like the child controls the ball. He can throw it any way he wants. Another order from Allah Azza wa Jalla, the salah. And that's, of course, we're going to talk in this topic. But that's an order from Allah Jalla, وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةِ إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ كَانَتْ عَنْ مُهِيلَ كِتَابًا مَوْقُوتًا وَإِنُ لِلْمُصَلِّينَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنْ صَلَاتِهِمْ سَاهُونَ فَخَلْفَ مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ خَلْفٌ أَضَاعُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَاتَّبَعُوا الشَّهَوَاتِ فَسَوْفَ يَلْقَوْنَ غَيًّا. Warning from Allah Jalla about the salah. You have to pray. So you have to follow the order of Allah Azza wa Jal. Also Allah Azza wa Jal tell us, be careful to backbite. أَيُحِبُّ أَحَدُكُمْ أَنْ يَأْكُلَ لَحْمَ أَخِيهِ مَيْتًا فَكَرِهْتُمُوهُ. When you, the Prophet ﷺ, he said he saw in the hellfire people they eating rotten meat. Who is Jibreel? That's the people needs to backbite. Rotten. Nobody can eat rotten meat. But that's the people needs to backbite. So Allah Azza and the Prophet ﷺ said, ولا تجسسوا ولا الله عز وجل سيد ولا تجسسوا ولا يقطع بعضكم بعض. أيحب أحدكم أن يأكل لحم أخيه ميتا؟ عند الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم سيد المسلم من سلم المسلمون من لسانه ويده. The true Muslims, he the one, he didn't harm the other Muslims with his tongue and his hand. That's a true Muslim. Not because I'm stronger than you, so I can't push you, I can't slap you, I can't. You are not a true Muslim, my brother. You don't know Islam. Allah, you don't know Islam. If you are true Muslims, من سلم المسلمون من لسانه ويده. That's what the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said. Not because I can talk better than you or I can backbite you somewhere, I do it. You don't know Islam. That's why we said the first things in our duty to know Islam. And then you start to go for the iman after that. Another thing, my brother, the hijab, Allah Azza wa Jal ordered the sisters. And the order come to the man as well. To tell his wife, to tell his sister, to tell his mother, to tell his daughter, to tell his auntie, to tell his cousins, whatever. tell them about the order of Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah Azza wa Jal said, يا أيها النبي قل لأزواجك وبناتك ونساء المؤمنين يدين عليهن من جلابيبهن. Order all the Muslims, women, and you women, to have the hijab. وليضربن بخمرهن على جيوبهن. That's an order from Allah Azza wa Jal to cover herself with the hijab. So you have to follow the order. Also Allah Azza wa Jal, He tell us to make dua to Him. وقال ربكم ادعوني استجب لكم. That's order. If you don't make dua, Allah become angry at you. If you don't ask Allah, Allah become angry at you. I always say that if somebody calls somebody 5-6 times to ask him money, after that he's going to say, brother, I can't. Don't come to my house, go to another brother. But for Allah Azza wa Jal, if you don't go every time to him, he become angry at you. So be careful, make dua. That's order from Allah Azza wa Jal. Also, to spend for sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. And another order, just to finish quickly, my brother, when you are having a good manner. The Prophet ﷺ said in the hadith, تخلقوا بأخلاق الله. Have a manner of Allah Azza wa Jal. And Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said, أقربكم إلي مجلسا يوم القيامة أحسنكم أخلاقا. The very close person to me in the judgment day, the one he have the best manner. The one who got good manner, he will be closer to the Prophet ﷺ in the judgment day. And wallahi, my brother, these positions, you will dream about it in this time. You can have it from now if you have a good manner. If you have a respect to the elder, if you have a mercy for the youngest, if you have that good attitude with the Muslim and non-Muslim, if you respect the people not because of culture or because of race or because of which country, whatever, for Allah Azza wa Jalla, you love the people for the sake of Allah, all the good manner. You have mercy, you have all the things. Wallahi, my brother, the Prophet said, you will be next to me in the judgment day. All of us will know what it means judgment day. And another order, Allah Azza wa Jal, or the Prophet ﷺ, he tell the people to do the good things for the others. لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يحب الأخي ما يحب. You're not going to be a true believer until you love to your brother what you love for yourself. You're not going to be a true believer unless if you love to your brother what you love for yourself. I love for myself to have a house for $5 million. And wallahi, I love for my brother Mustafa to have the same house. I love for brother Rooney to have the same house. I love for brother Shafiq to have 10 million, not 5 million. Because he got Yusuf now, so I have to increase his budget now. So it's like, wallahi, my brother, when you think about it, that's a true believer. That's order from the Prophet ﷺ and order from Allah Azza wa Jal also. So many orders. Check the order of Allah Azza wa Jal, my brother, all the time. And remember that, as we said, the last thing, I will end with it, inshaAllah. حب الله. To love Allah Azza wa Jalla. One of the ulama, somebody asked him, he said, will it make the Muslim now in this situation? He said, because you love the eight and you need love the three. You love eight things, but you need love the three. So the eight things, as Allah Azza wa Jalla mentioned that in the Quran, قُلْ إِنْ كَانَ آبَاؤُكُمْ وأبناؤكم وإخوانكم وأزواجكم وعشيرتكم وأموال اقترفتموها وتجارة تخشون كسادها ومساكن ترضونها. Eight things. أبناؤكم, your children. If, Allah Azza wa said, if your children, your fathers, first your fathers, your parents, second, your children, third, your brothers, fourth, your wives, fifth, your tribe, six, your money, seven, your business, eight, your house. Eight things. If you love them more than Allah and Muhammad and to make jihad fi sabilillah, Allah Azza wa Jalla said, فَتَرَبَّصُوا حَتَّى يَأْتِيَ اللَّهُ بِأَمْرِهِ. Allah Azza wa Jalla will destroy you. If you love these eight, and you don't love the three, so we should to make it opposite, my brother. We love Allah Azza wa Jalla first, and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and to do our jihad, the best effort for the da'wah. If you love these three more than the eight, the situation of the whole ummah will change. But because now we love the eight, and we don't love the three, that's where the sickness of the Ummah right now. So inshallah we'll end it now because we have some time for a special night tonight, and we're going to have another special night inshallah with Brother Shafiq, alhamdulillah. Allah give him a grandchild. And the good thing about that, I'm not worried about the grandchild. I'm worried because his name is Yusuf as well. So that's the good thing about it, mashallah. So, and his name is Yusuf Rahim, mashallah. So it's a very cute boy. And today we're having a little sweet for Yusuf. And inshallah soon everybody will be invited for his aqiqah, inshallah. So we make dua for him, inshallah. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to raise him in Islam and to make him a good boy for his mother and father and the grandfather and grandmother, of course. And to make him, inshallah, from the Hafidh of the Quran, and to grant him the Jannah, inshallah, and to make him one of the good dua for our deen, inshallah. So, أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين وجزاكم الله خيرا.